my honor and privilege to be here and speak in front of the ministers, member of parliaments, IPU secretary general, government official, ambassadors, civil society organizers, scientists, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. As you know that IPU is bringing a resolution on universal health coverage, achieving universal health coverage by 2030, the role of parliaments in ensuring the right to health. We are working on this resolution for last over a year, and we will be probably adopting in the next meeting in October in Belgrade in the IPU Assembly. As you know, I have been asked to talk about IPU debate on universal health coverage and linkage between the universal health coverage and global health security. As you know, that IPU assemblies are held twice in a year and are attended by over 1,000 delegates from member parliaments as well as associate members and partners. They provide a forum of parliamentarians around the world to discuss and make a contribution to the democracy, human rights, and major social and economic challenges, including health. The last IPU assembly was held in Doha in April 2019 and was attended by over 800 parliamentarians from 160 countries. On the occasion, a debate on universal health coverage enabled IPU members to share their views on ways to achieve universal health coverage by 2030 and propose parliamentary action to be included in the IPU resolution on universal health coverage. This constitutes an important step in the preparation of resolution as it allows gathering inputs and ideas from countries with diverse national context and level of development to inform the development of draft by Korea. 33 delegates, including 31 IPU member parliaments, took the floor to share some of the programs and policies to advance universal healthcare in their countries, as well as remaining challenges in ensuring equitable access to healthcare and addressing the multifaceted dimension of universal health coverage. The discussion also highlighted some key principles on universal health coverage and the linkage between universal health coverage and global health security as two sides of the same coin. Universal health coverage poses a challenge to all countries, but no single way to USC exists. The approaches must be tailored to the specific national context and priorities while still observing the underlying principle on health as a basis of human rights, equity, justice, and solidarity. Universal health cover is therefore not only centered to the health, but also developmental social inclusion and cohesion. Universal healthcare includes both technical and political agendas, but concrete action towards the universal health cover is ultimately a political choice, requiring strong political leadership and investment at the national level. Every country can therefore move towards universal healthcare regardless of income level of that country. Universal health coverage must cover the full spectrum of essential health services, with a particular emphasis on education, health promotion, prevention to child empower, prevention to empower individual with regards to their health and address underlying risk factor on ill health. Universal health cover must encompass both physical and mental health to help eliminate the stigma and discrimination associated with mental illness and promote access to professional health. Global health security in that debate in the IPU in Doha highlighted the need for health system to be sustainable and resilient. The strengthening of health system in all their aspects in prerequisite not only for universal health coverage but also global health security. Universal health coverage is an investment in safety as strong health system are the only assurance of adequate response to diseases, outbreak, and health crises. In an interconnected world, universal health coverage and global health security are everybody's concern, as no one is safe when there is an epidemic. In this context, the implementation of the international health regulation is crucial, with the view of strengthening primary health care provision and establishing a system of prevention to address the crises early on. In order to ensure equitable access to healthcare services for all, particular emphasis must be placed on regarding vulnerable and marginalized population, as well as on transparent and accountable governance for health. Thank you, everybody. Thank you very much.